That's December 17th, making his way now. Genaro Gomez, San Diego, California, where he's grown up. There you see his dad with the thick mustache, La Brocha, Luis Gomez. Bubba Garcia in the middle. Mikey Garcia making an appearance. Hector Tanahata Sr. with the glasses. Building it up as Genaro Gomez, 2-0. Co-main. So when they throw you in as a co-main at 2-0, do you mean that means Oscar really likes you?
Yeah. Yes. Yeah, and Oscar is extremely high on Gomez.
We're talking with President Eric Gomez just about some of these young guys over the summer. He's like, Gomez has an aura about him, an it factor. Same thing that Robert Diaz said. It's like, there's something about him.
I spoke with Eric Gomez about 2 weeks before the Summer Olympics, and I asked Eric, will Golden Boy be a player for some of these Olympians? And he said, you know, Steve, we're not going to get stupid and overpay for anybody. I like our cast of young kids, and I think certainly Gomez is part of that group.
Gomez, 21. Joshua Franco, 21. You have Hector Tanahara, 19. We just saw Alexis Rocha, 19. The youngsters, in, put a baseball equivalent, low A ball, are really loaded.
Listen, a young kid that we saw his pro debut, Cesar Diaz, he's coming back November 18th to this very same venue.
Genaro Gomez. Got the hair looking smooth. Cuñado on his side wearing the red shirt. That's Golden Boy staff bringing him in.
And he likes this. This walk to the ring, there's no butterflies. There's nothing but enthusiasm and anticipation because he believes he is a born fighter. This is what he was meant to do, get in there and get it on in prize fights.
And he comes into El Sinaloense. His dad from Perico, Sinaloa in Mexico. El Sinaloense, if you go to a Dodger game, you watch Julio Urias pitch, this is the song he comes into. Vernon Alston in the ring. Genaro Gomez ready to go. Our co-main, 6 rounds in the super featherweight division. You can go to the Golden Boy Twitter account. Who will win, Petrov or Perez? Earlier on, Petrov was up 56%. Where is it at now?
All right, Perez with some port.
Weppa, they're watching us in Jersey, huh?
Hey, listen, he's got the youth. 26 years old. Petrov, 33, and a lot of fights, 43 professional fights. That's wear and tear, but it's also experience.
As El Sinaloense finishes up, our ring announcer from Tijuana is ready to go. Steve Kim from Montebello ready to go. Dougie from Inglewood ready to go.
Damas y caballeros, este es el combate coestelar de esta noche. Pactado a 6 rounds en la división de peso ligero. And now, ladies and gentlemen, this is your co-main event of the evening. 6 rounds of boxing in the lightweight division. Your 3 judges scoring. Sus 3 jueces, Alejandro Rochin, Rudy Barragán, y Zachary Young. And when the action begins, your 3rd man, el tercero en la superficie, Tony Cribbs. Introducing to you first the fighter standing in the blue corner wearing silver and red. Official weight, 131 pounds. Presentando ustedes en la esquina Tecate Azul, vistiendo calzoncillo plata con rojo, con un peso de 131 libras. Professionally, he stands with 9 victories, 6 losses, 1 draw, and 7 of those victories coming by the way of knockout. Presenta un récord de 6 victorias, 9 victorias, 6 derrotas, 1 empate, y 7 de esas victorias por la vía del knockout. Fighting out of Durham, North Carolina, Vernon Alston. And his opponent across the ring, standing in the red corner, wearing black trunks with gold trim. Official weight, 134 pounds. Y su rival, peleando en la esquina Tecate Roja, vistiendo calzoncillo negro con dorado, con un peso de 134 libras. Professionally, he stands with 2 victories, and those 2 victories coming by the way of knockout. Presenta un récord de 2 victorias y esas dos victorias por la vía del knockout. Representando San Diego, California, Estados Unidos. Damas y caballeros, Genaro, el Conde Gámez. Y para dar las instrucciones finales, aquí está Tony Krebs.
Vernon, coach. Genaro, coach. Okay, guys, your trunks are great. Obey my commands and protect yourselves at all times. Touch gloves. Good luck. Go back and wait for the bell.
Tony Krebs, third man in the ring. Look at the tail of the tape.
Gámez, at age 21, is 7 years younger. He is 2 inches taller, but Alston has a very slight reach advantage.
Genaro Gámez, 21, started boxing as a young kid. His dad actually boxed a couple times professionally in Mexico. Dad mentioned it, trains a couple fighters, but now all the attention is on his son, Genaro Gámez. He's 21 years old, has an older brother, also boxed, not as a pro, but has an older brother. Gámez, fighting family, younger brother also boxes. Dad nicknamed El Gallito. He's now training his son alongside Robert Garcia. Genaro Gámez, two fights in the books, both first round knockouts. Turned pro in April. Second fight was in June.
As I said earlier, the style you see right now from Gámez, this is exactly how he fought as an amateur. He had a professional style as an amateur and was good enough to be a U.S. national champion.
Good right hand from Gámez early on. Body work from Gámez, attacking, going upstairs again. El Conde. The nickname, he means he used to condemn his opponents as an amateur. He's trying to do that now, and he drops Alston here early in the first round. A lot of friends and family driving up from San Diego, and Gámez has Alston going here in the first. Alston, 9-6-1 in his career. He's getting worked. That left hook got him, body work. Gámez is coming in quickly, trying to end it. Good right hand, body work, upstairs, going is Gámez.
You notice Gámez does not waste any punches.
No, he doesn't.
You got him? Yeah.
He literally landed in our lap, ladies and gentlemen, and Beto Duran actually saved him from falling on his head.
Yeah, Tony Krebs has waved the fight off. Sometimes the fighter will get 20 seconds to get back into the ring if he's in condition to, but Krebs recognizes that he's out of it.
Well, I'll say this. Gámez with the victory, Beto Duran with the save.
Good job, Beto.
That was crazy. Like, no, like, he literally fell through the ropes right at me, and I caught him. If I don't put my hands out, he gets the floor.
Yeah, and that's no good. This is a hard concrete floor.
Let's check out the replay from the knockout from Gámez.
Gámez on the attack, Alston against the ropes, and he got nailed with a hook while he was tied up in the ropes. Here's another angle of it, a better angle.
Oh, though, that left.
Those lefts and right under the chin, and Beto with the save.
Jeez.
Great job, Beto.
I thought Gámez actually fought at a more measured pace, maybe trying to get in a round or two. Bottom line is, Alston just didn't catch very well.
Now, his punch resistance has never been that good, but he is a very quick and athletic game opponent. He's the kind of guy to give most fighters who are just 2-0 some trouble, at least take him a few rounds. Gámez, he's just too polished in there. His confidence is something else for a guy with just three fights under his belt now and having never been out of the first round.
You know, it's what they used to describe Fernando Vargas as a young prospect. Instead
precocious.
Of being not ferocious, but precocious.
Yeah.
There you see his dad, Luis Gámez. Y saludos a todos de Perico, Sinaloa, El Pachuco. Miraron a su muchacho con el knockout in the primer round. Four brothers in the Gámez family. They saw their youngest brother with the first round KO. I'm still trying to gather myself around here. Don't mind me here.
Beto, I'm going to call you Eric Gagne.
Jeez.
You got the save. Seriously. I'll call you Allstate. Good hands.
Dude, but the thing is, though, he was out.
Yes, he was.
His body was limp right here.
Yes, it was.
Like, myself and the timekeeper had to push him back in there.
There, the left. I'm sorry, the left and then follow up right. But these lefts right here. That one right there and then this one right on the nose. And he's out. He doesn't have control of his body.
And that's my blue shirt. Save him.
You go. You and the timekeeper.
Wow.
Beto.
At this point, you guys have much better reflexes than Alston does.
Wow.
And there you see his face. He was completely out.
You keep him from hitting this hard concrete floor, which, well, you know, it could save his life.
It's the chair. Where this chair is at right here, there's nothing.
Yeah.
He would have gone straight down
Beto,
there.
All-State Duran.
How about Gennaro Gomez with a 3-0, 3 KOs, 3 professional fights, all first round knockouts.
And you know, Beto, on a serious note, that's why the length of the ropes, the height, like you look at this bottom rope, you just wonder based on what happened, should it be a little bit lower? And in fact, the fourth rope was put in to actually save fighters from awkward falls and fighters kind of getting out of the ring and getting caught up. That happened about 30, 40 years ago, that change.
Right. And in fact, there were some fighters that died that way.
Yes.
There was a fighter from Springfield, Ohio, featherweight champ, Davey Moore. And he got caught in that middle rope and his head hit.
Yeah.
You know.
And there you see that rope right in front of us right here. That's the one that was added on, as you mentioned.
Yeah.
The good news, Vernon Alston on his feet in his corner. Doctors checked him out quickly.
I'm glad he's okay.
Yeah.
He's looking up.
He just never got started tonight.
No. Well, how could he?
No. Well, he's somebody that if you give him the room, if you give him the space and time, and he gets in his rhythm, he's very dangerous because he's very quick, explosive, and athletic, but Gomez is just very good at getting in range, and when he's in range, he lets the right punches go at the right time, and everything is heavy and accurate.
Yvette Gianna Luis El Cabezon is the family members for Gennaro Gomez. Luis actually always tells him, throw the uppercut and body shots, the younger one. Well, he paid attention. There you see one of his brothers also, all of them amateurs. Southwest High alum in San Diego. Oh, he's going to go back to the 619, 3-0 with 3 KOs. Steve, you were talking about how Eric Gomez told you they didn't sign any Olympics, but the young staple for Golden Boy, and it's not hyperbole from us, it's not because we work for them, but these are kids who are legit making name for themselves quickly.
Yeah, and they have that look. And so sometimes, even though they're not tested, they don't have the track record, as Larry Merchant would say, sometimes you have to trust your eyes. I mean, when I see a Virgil Ortiz, Doug, I say to myself, I would buy stock in that guy.
Right.
Gennaro Gomez, good thing I didn't use all my strength playing golf this morning. played actually here at Eagle Glen, at Fantasy Springs with Mario Ruiz, works at ESPN. And maybe I should save my energy for tonight. Who knew I was going to save a guy coming through the ropes?
And, on a serious note, this is why the commission, as we look at the ring apron and you see what is around, a lot of the tables, they are all actually very, very much sticklers for what sticks out, how far our screens are, where the tables are set up, because of what happened to Mr. Alston.
Use the hashtag RingTV. We'll read your tweets later on tonight.
1:30 in el primer asalto. We have the official time of 1:30 coming into round number one. Declaring your winner by the way of knockout. Su ganador por la vía del knockout. Y aún invicto, Puritito San Diego, California. Gennaro, el Conde Gomez.
El Sinaloense can jam again. Gomez officially gets it as Vernon Alston is escorted out of the ring, walking out of the ring, great sign. He was just caught.
Oof.
And Steve, you said this to Alexis Rocha, or Doug, you said to Alexis, nothing on you, first round, you can come back in 3 weeks.
If your hands are healthy, your face is clean, why not come back in 2 weeks if you can come back in 2 weeks?
Well, we have them next week. I think the card at Blas is already full.
Yeah, that one's that's filled up, but maybe
November 5th? November 18th here.
November 18th here. Or maybe December 17th in Inglewood at the Forum.
Yeah, let's look at the Golden Boy calendar. Next Friday, Golasco about to sell out. Go and get those tickets there. November 5th, Emilio Sanchez is the co-feature on that. Who's the main on that one?
I don't think that's been decided yet.
That'll be there. But that'll always sell. First Friday of the month at Golasco, always fun. November 18th, back here at Fantasy Springs. Mauricio Herrera, Pablo Cano, that'll be a good one. Herrera brings all that Riverside crowd with him. And then December 17th at the Forum, Steve said, it's fighters that Golden Boy works with in Mura and
Salido.
Orlando Salido.
The Salido. and you can throw the Golden Boy fighters on there.
Yeah, and one note about Francisco Vargas. My understanding is that he has to fight his WBC number one contender, Miguel Roman. Now, after he takes care of that obligation, at that point, then he's going to have to fight the winner of December 17th, Salido and Miura. So there's a lot of good stuff going on at 130.
Yeah, you tweeted, oh, your boxing calendar, Steve, is all quiet. All you had were Miami games.
Yeah.
All of a sudden.
Well, here's the thing. The next 4 weeks, we're calling it Darktober because they are going dark. In essence, the game of boxing, I think they're stepping aside for the World Series, the football season. Let's face it, not a lot going on at the top level. But, Doug, from November 5th to about December 17th, as you said, I don't think any sane, rational boxing fan can complain.
We'll be back with more in Indio, California. You're watching Ring TV. Back here ringside in Indio, California, Fantasy Springs Resort and Casino. Beth Duran, Doug Fisher, and now joined by the man of the moment, Genaro El Conde Gámez. 3-0, 3 KOs. Did you even? No, you did break a sweat, right?
Okay. I did.
How did you feel in there?
In the dressing room, not during the fight.
I feel great. I did a great training camp, and I was just doing my thing.
Did you do your homework on Alston? Because looking at some stuff on him on YouTube, he's an athletic guy, very quick. Very mobile. Do you watch him and did you come up with a game plan or you just always fight your fight?
Yeah, they showed me the fight. I saw a little bit. I don't really watch my opponents. I let my team look at it. But like I told you guys one time, once I get in the ring, that's when I really study my boxer because you never it's never the same opponent. Like if he fought, I saw how he fought, but I didn't study him.
You came out right away, really. Controlled. It not like we've seen other guys that have only two records. They come out and they're just going so fast. You have a calm approach. Just look at the highlights from the first round. Because you came out real aggressive and throwing some bigger punches. What do you see here?
Oh, well, first of all, I see a cute guy.
Yeah, there you go. That was that right to start it off. What do you see here?
You know, it was just putting some punches together, getting warm up. But you know, punches landed and I got a knockout again.
This is a highlight reel knockout because you knocked him out of the ropes and it was over. How does it feel in just your third pro fight to have that kind of knockout that goes viral, that's on YouTube, that people buzz about?
It feels awesome, and I'll keep doing it over and over. If the opponent's on my level, I'll keep doing the same thing.
What's it like working with Robert Garcia? I know your dad's the main trainer, but you have Robert there in your corner also.
Yeah, Robert, it's a great inspiration. He's a great manager. He supports my team a lot, me and my dad. Everyone, and I'm really appreciative. I'm very thankful with him. And it feels great having a great person in my corner. And he told me tips and everything. But yeah.
Hey, who do you spar with there?
This training camp?
Yeah.
I spar Michael Perez, the next one.
Oh,
we got some work
in. That's good work.
Yeah, we got some work.
For
good
both
work.
Of you.
Yeah. And I think he's 100% ready. And I spar him. I spar Billy Dib.
Okay.
You know, yeah, I saw him 2 rounds.
Former featherweight
from Australia.
Title
yeah,
from Australia.
Great man. Shout out to him. He's
great
a great
guy.
Person. Yeah, great guy.
You came out
really
to
awesome.
El Sinaloense, Los Pericos, Sinaloa. They're all excited out there.
Yeah.
Un
saludo a toda mi raza de allá de Perico, Sinaloa, todo Sinaloa, a toda mi familia. Les mando un abrazo y un beso a los que conozco y a los que no conozco y a toda la gente de San Diego, Tijuana, Ensenada, todo México y todos Estados Unidos.
¿Y el cabezón qué?
Oh, El Cabezón. I couldn't bring him. He's in school.
Your little
son.
Brother.
It's my nephew.
Oh, it's your nephew. That's right.
It's my brother's son. My brother, the one who passed away, and he called me dad now. He's my son.
El Cabezón. Yeah. Your dad, El Pollito, is all excited.
Yeah,
there you go. They got to go talk to you back there.
Okay.
He's ready to go.
Thank you.
Genaro El Conde Gámez.
I want to give a big shout out to my Uncle Rob from Autosport. Autosport. He hooked me up with a sick-ass system for this time.
Look at you. Get down. There you go. He's
Thank
now 3-0, 3 KOs in the first round. Our main event is coming
Thank
up
you.
Between
Thank
Peter
you.
Petrov and Michael the Artist Perez. We'll be back with more in Indio on Ring TV.